The world is not doing enough to help people displaced by war. That was the message during a visit by the UN High Commissioner for Refugees. Filippo Grandi was in Tehran to meet with Foreign Minister Javad Zarif and other senior leaders. His trip just days before the presidents of Iran, Russia and Turkey hold three-party talks in Tehran.
I have just been to Syria, so I reported back to the government of Iran about my observations. First and foremost, especially in my meeting with Minister Zarif, we spoke about our concerns about Idlib. It is clear that the risks of a military confrontation causing massive loss of life is very high. And I told Minister Zarif that my appeal, just like the UN Secretary General and others, is let's minimize, the appeal to the parties is for them to minimize the loss of life.
Grandi said Syrian refugees, who wonder if it's safe to go home, are watching how the conflict plays out in its final stages. It could send a message of confidence, he said, or not. In the last few days, the Kremlin has labeled Idlib province a hotbed of terrorists that requires action. Syrian government forces backed by Russian air power have been moving into the area, and armed groups fighting President Bashar al-Assad are preparing for their last stand. For Damascus, a decisive victory in Idlib would bookend a brutal civil war. For Tehran, that would mean going from the expensive task of supporting an ally in large-scale military operations to the more lucrative work of reconstruction. After a surprise visit to Damascus earlier this week, Iran's foreign minister said rebuilding Syria is an opportunity for Iranian companies, but preserving life is still a priority.
The conditions in Idlib are sensitive. We're trying to deal with the situation there and expel terrorists with the least humanitarian costs. We had talks in Turkey to this end, and we also held talks in Syria with the high-ranking officials.
Of the three countries due to meet in Tehran, Turkey is the only one hosting large numbers of Syrian refugees. Ankara supports some of the armed fighters in Idlib and is worried a military solution will mean more displaced civilians.
World leaders who fueled a civil war for years are already talking about returning refugees and reconstruction. But the lives of people who lived in the cities these men mean to rebuild are still at risk. Zein Basravi, Al Jazeera, Tehran.